Pedro and Sophia Alvarez. They're acclaimed tango teachers here in Wellington for the New Zealand Tango Festival. They join us right now. Welcome to Good Morning. How are you?
Oh, great. How are you?
Nice to have you here.
Kia ora.
Kia ora. Kia ora.
Good morning.
Good morning.
How are you?
Very good. Now, explain to us, I guess, the dance that you've just performed now, because it's very improvised, isn't it?
That's right.
Is that how the tango is danced a lot of the time?
Well, there are two forms of tango. Mm-hmm. There's the stage tango and the social tango,
right,
which is also called salon. And the most common form of tango is salons, the social, right, which is the one that's danced all around the world. And what you often see on shows and in the movies is the stage tango.
Yeah.
But we love the social tango because it's totally improvised. And in fact, because of that, it's called a moving meditation.
Right.
Because you have to be totally in the moment, because you don't know what's happening from moment to moment.
I think that's wonderful, because I've been to Cuba and over there dancing the salsa and stuff. It's exactly the same. You sort of go in there, you must know, or you also must know how to lead. That's an important thing that you got to let the people know as well, like when you are dancing. Yes. As well. Pedro, how long have you been dancing for?
Oh, I've been dancing for as long as I remember. Mm-hmm. When I was young, I worked in a tango place back in Argentina. I was too young to appreciate it fully. But I thought it was a dance for older people.
Really?
Yeah, when I grew up, not many young people used to dance tango. But it changed over the year. These days, lots of young people are into tango.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. Then we moved to Australia in the 80s, and there was no tango there, so...
So you've introduced it because you have your own tango studio over there, you teach people dance?
We haven't introduced it. It was
there before?
Yes, yeah. But we're definitely involved in helping promote it.
So how important, how many people are getting out and learning the tango nowadays? There seems to be a lot more.
Oh, definitely, it's growing. Some people call it the new salsa.
Really? Now, how did you guys meet? Because you're from New Zealand.
Yeah.
You're from Dunedin.
That's right.
So how did you...
Well, actually, I grew up in Auckland.
Right, so how did you meet Pedro?
Well, I met him at a salsa party.
Really? So it is a place to meet your partner.
I met Pedro
at a
salsa ring.
Right.
Because we love salsa as well.
And obviously, you love salsa so much, but is that how it all started? And I guess it blossomed from there.
Oh, yeah. Certainly.
Yeah. It started in salsa. Our courtship was salsa.
Right.
And then I got more into tango thanks to Pedro, which is something I'd always wanted to learn.
Mm-hmm.
And then after this tango, I really didn't have much time for salsa. Much as I like it, I still love tango more. It's something that is very deep and it's very connecting, and I can't explain it. You really have to do it to experience it.
How difficult is it to learn?
It's hard to tell from this, but...
Right.
But it requires a bit of patience and time. Is over time, and the subtlety is the hardest part to learn.
Right.
But
you got to feel it, eh? It's like any dance, eh? You've got to feel it.
But there's a technique based on the walk, because we emphasize a lot the walk and embrace. For us, tango is embrace,
mm-hmm.
and the way we walk. So then we create our own way of dancing. There's no basic steps in tango.
Yeah, because I was watching you before, and you don't want to get your footwork wrong, because you're very close on a lot of the footwork. It does have to be precise, otherwise you could stand on one another's feet. Yeah.
But if you're dancing socially, you can dance simpler than that, and you don't need to do the complicated footwork.
Right.
And in some ways, some people find tango easier than salsa, because you don't have to move your hips in the same way. It's a different way of moving the body.
Right.
Some people find they're naturally suited to tango, and people that have never danced before, and they get really surprised that they actually find it easy.
Right.
They thought they couldn't dance because they couldn't memorize moves and steps. Well, we say you don't have to. There's basically only six steps in tango.
Now, this is the seventh year that the festival's being held, and apparently there's been so many more people that are coming along this year. What can people expect to come along to the festival?
They can expect really great workshops, and tomorrow there's a great, fantastic show by the World Tango Champions of Stage, Gisela and Gaspar, and also Anna and Fabio, who are the World Tango Stage Champions in Australia, and it's on at the Michael Fowler Centre, and you can get tickets from Ticketek tomorrow night.
It's another night in
Buenos Aires. Open to the general public.
And that's something that people shouldn't miss.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Spectacular show.
You enjoying being back here in New Zealand?
I love it.
Yeah.
Every time I come back, I think, why did I leave?
Do Kiwis love the tango dance and music?
They do, and they have enormous respect for tango. Mm. I really love that about Kiwis.
Right.
Yes.
Hey, well, it's an absolute pleasure to have you on the show. Thank you so
much.
Good luck with the festival this week, and nice to have you here on Good Morning.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. And for more on the Tango Festival, see